Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website, that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for August the 15th of 2019, well, it is titled The Perseids and the Plough. So what do we see here? Well, this is an image taken of the Perseid meteor shower, which peaked over the past couple of days and is one of the best meteor showers to be able to view. And you can see a number of the meteors here streaking across the sky. Now, a meteor itself is a small piece of dust or ice, little bit of material left over from a comet as it passed close to the sun. And it could have done that hundreds or thousands or more years ago. And as it passes close, some of the material is vaporized off of its surface and gets left behind. And what that does is it still follows the same orbit that the comet did. And when the Earth happens to pass through that orbit, then it collects this dust and it strikes the Earth's atmosphere at very high speeds, many times tens of thousands of miles per hour, and then vaporizes in the upper Earth's atmosphere. These small particles cannot make it down to the ground, so they'll never land here and become meteorites. They will simply burn up, and we will see them flashing across the sky as shooting stars or meteors. And that's what we're seeing here, is several of them imaged here. Now, this is actually a composite image put together from a number of different images. If you watch a meteor shower, you will not see lots of meteors at any given time. They will take time to appear. In fact, in a good strong meteor shower, you might see one or two a minute. So, and that's if you have a really dark sky. So here we're seeing a number of them going across the different parts of the sky here, and that means this was taken over about a 2-hour time period. Now, what is meant by the plough? Well, the plough is one of the most famous asterisms or grouping of stars in the sky, and you may better know it as the Big Dipper. So you can see the Big Dipper here, right across, in fact, straight centered in the image, with the 7 stars, 3 stars making up the handle, and then 4 stars making up the bowl of the Dipper. And the meteor shower happens to be right around that. But if you look at the meteors, they actually seem to be coming from a specific direction. If you trace them all back, they seem to be coming from a specific direction in the sky. And that is what is called the radiant point of a meteor shower. So all meteors coming in parallel will seem to converge at some point. And that is how they get their name, and that's for the constellation from which they appear to come. So in this case, they don't appear to be coming from the Plough or the Big Dipper. They're actually coming from a place off, up and above to the, and to the right of it. And that would be the direction of the constellation of Perseus, which is how the Perseids get their name. So meteor showers are named after the constellation from which they appear to radiate. Now, that appearance is just an optical illusion because they are all following the same orbit and coming in parallel. So, just as telephone poles or railroad tracks will appear to converge off in the distance, so will the meteors. And they will appear to be coming from the same point in the sky, but again, it is just an optical illusion, much as those railroad tracks converging off in the distance. So that was our picture of the day for August the 15th of 2019. It was titled The Perseids and the Plough. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Just So Story. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.